Hello, everybody.
Hi.
So it looks like my logo got blacked out. I apologize for that, but that's the black box is our logo. So I want to start off by saying thank you to Dave Silverman, to Nick Fish, and to American Atheists for giving me this opportunity. Last year, I received an email from Dave Niosi, the legal director for the Apignani Humanist Legal Center, about reaching and supporting secular kids. In it, he quoted Matt Staver, the Liberty Counsel attorney representing the infamous anti-gay Kentucky clerk Kim Davis. It read, "If you want to change the face of the planet, you want to focus on those children ages 5 to 12. It's the most strategic age group that we have." To that, David Niosi had this to say. "Such a quote coming from a high-profile religious fundamentalist may seem a bit eerie, but in fact, Staver's right. The outcome of the culture wars could very well be decided by today's youth. This is why the religious right invests so heavily in strategies that target kids. And this is also why the secular community needs to reach and support young people. In my presentation today, I'm going to address this issue and to show why Camp Quest is vital to the atheist movement." Camp Quest is an overnight summer camp for kids 8 to 17 years old. But it's not just a summer camp. It's a youth development experience. We believe that well-adjusted, critical thinking, and compassionate youth can indeed change the world. Our programs nurture our next generation's growth mindset by empowering them with critical thinking skills, engaging them in ethical thought processes, preparing them to engage respectfully with those who hold different beliefs, and we all know they're going to find those, inspiring natural wonder, and validating their self-identity. Camp Quest's founders created an organization to provide a safe, welcoming, humanistic community for youth to grow, belong, and discover the world for themselves. Since 1996, we have grown from 20 campers in Kentucky to a nationwide movement. 20 years later, in 2016, we served 1,206 campers across the course of 17 weeks and served by 470 volunteer adult leaders. Throughout its history, Camp Quest has always been committed to accessibility and inclusion. And since our beginning, we focused on inclusion of campers from families that had no religious affiliation or that were outright atheists. When it comes to religious affiliation, recent studies have shown that the percentage of nuns has risen dramatically in recent years, and this lack of affiliation is most concentrated in young adults. Why are the nuns rising so dramatically, especially among young people? Why are people leaving the church? It's because the church has antiquated views on gays and sex and race, and young people don't want to be involved with it. They see the church's discriminatory views, for instance, those of the Mormon church on people of color and how that's played out, and they want nothing to do with it. But at Camp Quest, we don't want to stop with people leaving the church. Dropping indoctrination and dogmatic belief is just the first step. We want our young people to be not just non-religious, but to additionally embrace the values of humanism, the evidence-based approach of skepticism, and the self-determination of free thought. We as a movement must recognize that to stay relevant, our members must be engaged. That means looking around to what matters to people. We must reach the next generation, and we must address real-world problems facing our members. The rise of the nuns means that a large majority of secular parents are first-generation secular parents. And they give us no manual for parenting in general, and certainly no manual for being secular parents. But Camp Quest gives us the opportunity to rewrite traditions, to break the cycle, and to rebuild it. This is a time where it's not only appropriate, but crucial to reinvent the wheel. We must not just look for alternatives, for secular alternatives as, for our children as they grow up, but we must also find ways to truly engage them so that they stay engaged as adults. We must find ways to ignite their passion for equality, justice, and value of human life so that as adults, they will be competent and compassionate future leaders of the movement. Everyone here, I'm sure, is familiar with Recovering from Religion. As an organization, they provide wonderful resources like secular therapy, the Hotline Project, and support groups. For people that are broken by religion and are damaged by religion, this is invaluable. But our job at Camp Quest, if we are successful in building a solid base of whole and healthy children, there will be no need for organizations like Recovering from Religion. So it's our goal, sorry Gail, but to put Gail Jordan and Recovering from Religion out of business. What we call ourselves has proven to be a contentious topic among organizations and individuals in the atheist movement. At Camp Quest, we don't label the children. If we focus too much on what we call ourselves, then we don't have the bigger conversations. We are a secular people navigating a religious world. We must equip our children with skills to successfully navigate their experiences. Instead of teaching them to call themselves atheists, we instead focus on encouraging them to think critically and question things and to expect the same from their peers. Instead of asking what kind of label best suits us, we are more interested in what kind of world we want to live in and how do we get there. We know that to make real inroads into a community, we have to help people be able to separate themselves from harmful family traditions, which can be difficult. I'm sure that we all have personal experience or know somebody that has personal experience with that. When you aren't comfortable in your skin and you can't go to family, what do you do? And how do we overcome this? This is especially true for members of the Black and Hispanic communities where religion and family are so important and family units tend to be more generational. The community that Camp Quest provides offers a safe space for these individuals to build and maintain their self-confidence and their self-determination. Camp Quest focuses on values and ways that our values play out. For instance, Black Lives Matter is all about questioning values. We have seen time and time again that police have values that cannot be questioned, therefore keeping the status quo. This has led to a public understanding that simply being Black is sufficient grounds for police interrogation, brutality, and worse. Mothers fear for their Black sons and raise them with a different reality than those of white sons. Black students are held to different standards in school and are overrepresented in disciplinary actions. These statistics, left unquestioned, will be detrimental to us all, Black, white, and everyone else. We must question the status quo. Our children must question the status quo. Oftentimes, kids' differences and questions are met with silence, violence, and hate. And their experiences and questions are often dismissed because they're just kids. Instead of telling kids that they aren't old enough to have these conversations, Camp Quest instead creates conversations with them about these very issues. In fact, we intentionally have these conversations to prepare kids for diversity and inclusion and to develop their sense of empathy. Both kids and parents respond positively to these conversations. They are enthusiastic about endorsing this type of dialogue because these conversations are not happening on a large scale and they want to reverse this trend. One of my favorite programs has been one on gender diversity. At Camp Quest, these issues come up and we discuss them openly without shame, encouraging our campers to think about the issues for themselves. I'm sure most of you, if not all of you, remember Leela Alcorn. She was a transgender teen in Ohio whose parents were unaccepting of her. Her story has a tragic ending. She threw herself in front of a semi-truck and died at the scene. Here are her final words. I have decided I've had enough. I'm never going to transition successfully, even when I move out. I'm never going to be happy with the way I look or sound. I'm never going to have enough friends to satisfy me. I'm never going to have enough love to satisfy me. I'm never going to find a man who loves me. I'm never going to be happy. Either I live the rest of my life as a lonely man who wishes he were a woman, or I live my life as a lonelier woman who hates herself. There's no winning. There's no way out. I'm sad enough already. I don't need my life to get any worse. People say it gets better, but that isn't true in my case. It gets worse. Each day, I get worse. That's the gist of it. That's why I feel like killing myself. Sorry if that's not a good enough reason for you. It's good enough for me. I'd like to now share with you another story. This story is about another transgender teen named Luke Reed. Luke had been registered to attend a summer camp. It was the same summer camp he had attended the year before, as his birth assigned gender, which was female. Unlike Leela, Luke has a supportive mother. This is a message that his mother sent to the camp director just before the start of camp that year. Just 2 days before camp was to start, I made a call to the camp director with a question. Could my daughter attend camp as a boy? Without hesitation, her answer was an enthusiastic yes. That week was an important one for us. It gave my kid the space, acceptance, and support he needed to be himself. That week helped us as a family begin the transition from having a daughter and a sister to having a happy son and brother. Without this opportunity, I wonder how much longer my child would have had to stay inside feeling stuck and unreal. The difference between these two transgender teens is stark. Indeed, it's a difference of life and death. I wish that Leela Alcorn had had a supportive network of peers and caring adults. Perhaps this would have ended quite differently for her. In addition to our commitment to serving children from secular families, we at Camp Quest are particularly proud to nurture LGBT youth. If you haven't figured it out already, that summer camp that Luke attended is Camp Quest, South Carolina. Our work with youth celebrates differences and encourages self-discovery. We are proud of how our culture was transformative for that family and for other families across the country. Providing transformative experiences for those who are different means being different ourselves. It means daring to be different and being on the cutting edge, which is not always easy. How many people have seen the Dancing Man video? It's the one where the shirtless guy is dancing around in an event with a bunch of music going on. Anyway, at first, he's just this single lone nut dancing away without a shirt in the middle of a bunch of people sitting around. But undeterred, he is at last joined by another person, and then another person, and then another person. And finally, there's an entire crowd dancing. And that guy is no longer the first lone nut, but the creator of a dance party. A movement is started by someone not just wanting, but willing to be different. Being first necessarily means taking risks with how you're portrayed. Remember Jessica Alquist a few years ago, who sued her high school, Cranston High School, because they had a religious prayer plaque in her auditorium? She was 17 years old, and had the courage to stand up for what she knew was right. But it came at a cost to her because there was a tremendous backlash against her in the form of hate mail, of violence and death threats even, from her peers and from media outlets and from even a state representative who called her an evil little thing. So yeah, she took risk with how she was portrayed, but I think she came out ahead. So like our camper Luke, Camp Quest realized that we had to take some risks in order to make the changes that needed to happen to equip our kids with the necessary skills to successfully navigate a religious world. We've done that, and we continue to do that. Over 20 years later, and we are still going strong. With Camp Quest, we also have an end game. We know what we're working for. We are redefining normal by redefining the values and opportunities that not just our kids, but all kids have access to. As I said before, Camp Quest is not just a summer camp experience for kids from non-religious families. It's not just a regular community service opportunity where atheist adults can go and volunteer some hours. Camp Quest is a professional youth development organization and as such consistently achieves the following outcomes for our campers. Children with an expectation of social acceptance do substantially better in school. Research shows that children who believe they belong are more likely to seek help, challenge themselves, and be resilient in the face of adversity. Camp Quest is committed to serving children who are often seen as outsiders. Our camps create experiences of belonging, and in doing so, we arm children with powerful tools for future educational success and active citizenship. Our outcomes show that Camp Quest cultivates empathy, and that motivates our campers to work towards human rights and social justice. Camp Quest gets kids outside and into the natural world, connecting them with the environment and improving their mental and physical health. Outdoor play is essential to a child's healthy development. Beyond the health benefits of the outdoors, our campers learn about evolution and environmental science. They connect with natural ecosystems and develop a sense of environmental responsibility. Camp Quest challenges campers to overcome obstacles, take positive risks, and have new experiences. Camp offers youth an intensive opportunity for personal growth, increased responsibility, and self-discovery, all of which contribute to a growth mindset. Even seemingly basic struggles like overcoming homesickness or being challenged to solve problems and think critically are powerfully transformative for children, resulting in increased independence, resilience, confidence, and self-motivation. Camp is joyful. It's focused on what is good and on collaboration. We are building a world of hope by building hopeful children. We are making a more compassionate world by instilling values of empathy and diversity in our children. So where do we go from here? Camp Quest Southeast currently serves the 7 southeastern states of North and South Carolina, Tennessee, Mississippi, Georgia, Alabama, and Florida. This region's concentration of employment, poverty, fundamentalist religiosity, and discrimination against secular and LGBT people and people of color sets it apart. Focusing on this region allows us to serve children 8 to 17 who need Camp Quest the most because they have the least access to youth development opportunities that promote critical thinking, inclusivity, and evidence-based strategies for personal growth. As executive director of Camp Quest Southeast, I have developed an expansion plan that will triple the number of camps locations from our original single location in South Carolina to a total of 3 across our region by 2018, which is of course next year, and to add an additional 2 potential sites by 2021. I'd also like to look at adding a bilingual or Spanish-speaking only camp for Hispanic free-thinking Americans, either in Florida or potentially Puerto Rico. We began our plans for growth in 2015, and our first new camp was successfully operated this summer. Camp Quest. Camp Quest Natchez Trace was the first secular summer camp in Mississippi, the most underserved and in need state in our region. Groundwork has been laid for our next location to open in Central Florida, which will operate in August of next year. This year, Camp Quest Southeast served 148 kids between our two locations, and our goal is to next year serve 200 across our three locations. Our goal is to continue our expansion throughout the Southeast region to ultimately serve all kids so that they are all within a four-hour drive to a Camp Quest location. But we need your help. Each new camp costs about $10,000 to put into fruition. We are 100% volunteer run, but in order to expand and to bring new opportunities, a volunteer model is not sustainable. We need to have a person employed full-time to make this happen. We are also looking for additional volunteers to help staff our camps and camps across the country, not just those of Camp Quest Southeast. We need help in spreading the word to let other families, both families that are secular and even liberal Christian families, know that this is an amazing opportunity for their children to come and have an amazing week of fun, friends, and free thought. You can help make this happen. Our website is www.campquestsoutheast, and we have a donate button. Please go and help us make this a reality for the kids. Here at this conference are atheists, agnostics, freethinkers, and even Dave Silverman's favorite, humanists. While there is a great variation in our approach, we all believe that we have this one life, and it is up to us to make a difference. Let's be that difference. Let's redefine what is normal for our kids, and in doing so, redefine what is normal for atheists. This is why Camp Quest is vital to the atheist movement. Thank you.